But so, like,
so that's going to attract king snakes too. Just rat carcasses are lying around.
Well, yeah, but I mean, they're supposed to be scared of cats, aren't they?
Snakes?
Yeah.
I don't know, really.
I mean, won't they go like Ricky Ticky Tabby on that snake?
That's the mongoose. That's a mongoose and a king cobra. Two very different dynamics.
I feel like a cat is close to a mongoose.
Yeah, they're probably similar, but I don't know. The mongoose king cobra relationship has sort of that's a dynamic that's been built over time. I feel like house cats versus king snakes, that's something relatively new in the evolutionary chain. Wait, let's read the Google description. Are cats afraid of snakes? pets.thenest.com. Whether your cat should fear a snake or the snake should fear your cat depends on the snake. Humans are susceptible to a lot of myths about snakes. Lots of us grew up thinking they're slimy, dangerous, all poisonous, scary. Some psychology experts' fear of snakes is inborn. I get that. I've been afraid of snakes forever.
Yeah, I don't like them. I can't. Like, my husband's like, well, it's not scary. Just like, he's always like, if you don't mess with it, it won't mess with you. And I'm like, it will mess with me. It's evil. Like,
yeah, I think I had a Facebook friend who had a pet snake. I remember she posted a video of feeding it, and it, like, it had, like, the mouse in its mouth, and it hissed at her. Like, it is, like, it seemed like a fairly menacing hiss. And,
yeah.
And she just talked to her, like, don't you hiss it. Like, she just talked to it so frankly.
Like, it was like a cat hissing at her?
Yeah, like, if a snake hissed at me like that,
I'd be like, bye-bye.
Like, no. Like, burn the house down, move to another town.
Time to move to, yep.
Yeah, start life anew.
I need to freshen up this life. Yeah, no. That is, snakes are definitely, like,
that's a huge phobia.
I would say that's my number one fear, probably.
Snakes?
Yeah.
I don't think. I have heights. I'm afraid of heights, too.
I don't like heights, and I'm afraid of them, but, like, I can manage that fear if I need to, so that, like, if I was, like, on, like, a zip line or something, I could do it.
How high of a zip line are we talking?
Above the treetops. I've done that before.
That's pretty intense. I don't know if I could do that.
So, I mean, like, I can manage that fear. Like, oh, it scares me. But I can manage it. Like, the snakes is the one thing I cannot rationalize my way through it. Because, like...
You can never hold one, ever?
I cannot, no.
Okay. Yeah, I can't either.
I could not. We went with Adrian's elementary school to, like, the petting zoo. And they're like, here, hold the snake. I was like, no. I'll hold that thing that smells by the ferret.
The thing that smells by the ferret? The mm-hmm. poo?
No, the ferrets just stink.
Oh, they just stink? Okay.
No, they just smell like... Unripe skunk.
Yeah, unripe skunk. Okay, I've never heard it put exactly like that.
They're gross. Well, I was like, I'm not holding the snake. I'm not. And they're like, oh, it's a quote nice snake. There are no nice snakes. Like, stop trying to like PR this into me.
Yeah, I really don't understand the people who keep snakes.
And then I hate also like holes.
Oh yeah, we've discussed this before. Like beehives.
Yeah, like those things.
The tiny, the tiny holes.
And just thinking about
something to do with the symmetry too.
Yeah,
you?
If it's like asymmetrical, yeah. So it's not like in a pattern or uniform.
That messes with you.
Yes.
But if it's like a perfect beehive honeycomb, is that
no?
Okay?
That doesn't
bother. That's a cluster of holes.
That it depends on the size and the shape.
What is it exactly? A phobia of holes? Is that a real thing?
Yeah,
a phobia of holes.
Tryptophobia.
What?
Tryptophobia.
A fear of holes?
Yes.
Why?
I don't know. I can't explain it. I think it has something to do with the research they've done is like, it has something to do with like rotting flesh or something. Like, oh my God.
Okay, that's actual rotting flesh though. Do you have tryptophobia and they just show a hand with a series of holes? That looks legitimately disgusting. I can see why that freaks you out. But
I can't.
What about just a hole in the ground?
No, not like one single hole. Like, I'm not afraid of like.
What if we were planting like a banana tree garden and we had like a bunch of holes in the ground?
No, because it would probably be symmetrical. Like, you'd have like one every few feet or whatever.
like a little row of bananas.
Yeah, like that would not bother me.
That wouldn't freak you out.
Yeah.
But if we hate.
But like, let's say you had a strawberry and you peeled out all the seeds of the strawberry and handed it to me, I wouldn't be able to eat it. It would scare me.
Really?
Yeah.
You can't hold like a strawberry.
I can when it has its seeds and stuff in it. But if you were to pull it out so the seeds became holes, like it would scare me.
I don't understand. Like
it raises like my cortisol level and I can't.
I feel like I want to look this up when I get home, but I don't want that image either.
No.
Of the hand with all the holes in it.
Yeah.
Because that's legitimately kind of disturbing. I don't want to see that.
Yes, I'm saying, yeah, but no, that just, I couldn't like even right now I'm trying to like get that out of my head. Like I can't.
Like there weren't holes in that hand.
Like I can't feel my heart racing just thinking about that. Like okay, the holy hand.
What's the antidote to tryptophobia?
There is none.
Non-holes?
Yeah, to like not look at holes.